These tools have synergistic effects. Broaden your input. Don't forget to detect, reflect, reject biased thoughts, and think ahead. As I said, none of these tools is a magic bullet that applies in every instance. But when using them, you should be genuine and apply them thoughtfully. Although at first it will require effort to use these tools, if you practice them over time, they will require less effort and they can become automatic habitual responses themselves. Unintentional bias is a habit of mind, but you can break that habit if you have motivation to do so, awareness of different ways bias can play out, tools to reduce bias, and you put in effort over time. Everything you learned today can apply to biases related to any stereotyped social group, including race, gender, ethnicity, sexual orientation, political orientation, religion, and so on. You can expect that you're going to slip up and have biased thoughts, or maybe do or say something biased. You've had these stereotypes in your head for years. But if you return to what you learned today, research shows that over time, you can break the bias habit. Past research on this training approach has shown that even several years later, participants display much less unintentional bias. They're better at catching themselves before they fall prey to bias, and they're better at behaving in ways that are consistent with their intentions and values. You have the power to create change both within yourself and in the world around you. Thank you. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel. To be notified of when we post new videos, click the bell icon to turn on notifications. You can also go to biashabit.com to learn more, to donate, to sign up for our newsletter, or to contact us about evidence-based bias and DEI trainings. Thank you.